a member of this church for two decades. He was married by this reverend. His children were baptized in this church. It's not that he happened to walk into a room and Reverend Wright was there. He's been a member of this church, a member of Reverend Wright's flock for 20 years. Statements. He is like an old uncle who sometimes will say things that I don't agree with. And I suspect there are some of the people in this room who have heard relatives say some things that they don't agree with. An old uncle, he says. Senator, he only rejected these statements after these tapes became public.
Well, Chris, again, we can spend all morning talking about this. The American public have watching their foreclosure rates climb. Oil prices are going up.
They well, sir, you're changing the subject.
Well,
I'm asking you.
Well, of course, that's well,
this
the subject matter.
You don't think it's relevant that this man was a member of this church for two decades?
No, you've made it relevant.
And this fellow,
we've made it relevant here for the last 4 or 5 days in this network. But the fact of the matter is,
it's not just this network, sir.
I know, but the fact of the matter is, people like to move on to other things. I've answered your question.
Well, I'd like to. Well, no, I don't think you have answered it because you said that he answered it, that he rejected it very quickly. He didn't reject it quickly. The fact is, last month, when he's known about it, he said he's a crazy old uncle.
Well, going back and reviewing, at what point, who said what? Rejected them here. Whether he did it a month ago or a week ago, he's rejected them. I think that's the important point. And again, guilt by association here is something we've got to stay away from in this country. Anyone involved in public life, Chris, has been places, have been with people who have said and done things. We move on. He's rejected it.
Senator, it isn't a question of guilt by association. If you read Barack Obama's book, Dreams from My Father, he talks about what a huge role Reverend Wright played in his deciding his affirmation of his identity as an African American. He's been a member of this church for two decades. He was married by this reverend. His children were baptized in this church. It's not that he happened to walk into a room and Reverend Wright was there. He's been a member of this church, a member of Reverend Wright's flock for 20 years. Senator Schumer, are you troubled that Obama would belong to a church, be married by a minister, have his children baptized by a minister who says these kinds of things?
No, I agree with Chris here. Look, each campaign is wide-ranging. Supporters are all over the place. And you will find in every campaign, you have Senator McCain endorsed by a reverend who said very anti-Catholic things. You've had the problems our campaign had with certain statements that Geraldine Ferraro made. If you are going to ascribe what every supporter says, every word they say to the candidate themselves, you know, you're going to just be in an unproductive. We have major issues facing us in America, whether it's the war, the economy, and I do believe, you know, past elections have had too much emphasis on these things. This election won't, Chris, and the reason is people are worried about the future of the country and they want a real discussion on issues.
Well, let me just ask you, if I may, for just a moment. This isn't just a supporter. This is a man who was the head of his church for 20 years. Are you telling me, because I'm a little surprised at this, Senator, you're not troubled that that Barack Obama belonged to a church which had a Reverend Wright, who said that the U.S. has sponsored state terrorism through Israel against the Palestinians? That doesn't bother you?
I know Barack's views on Israel, and I think they're very strong. I mean, as